Hello, welcome to today's video where I'll be covering my webcomic process in quick video paint. In the previous video, I went over how I color my comic pages. Today I'll be discussing materials and reusable assets and how you can make your own. Links to additional tutorials and information for everything mentioned in today's video will be down in the description. When making a webcomic, relying on pre-made assets can help you save time and prevent overworking. These can be pre-drawn textures, patterns, speech bubbles, etc. Most professionals working on webcomics use materials like these, and it's a habit I recommend for every artist interested in making comics. Obsidio Paint comes with lots of materials that can be used freely in webcomics. You can view these materials by going to Window, Material, and choosing any folder. As you can see, each folder has plenty of assets you can easily add to your canvas by dragging and dropping them in. For my webcomic, I use a combination of default assets and ones I made myself. As you get further into drawing your comic, you may find yourself drawing the same thing again and again, and you can't find a pre-made asset for it. In that case, it helps to know how to make them yourself. Before making any assets, you'll need to know how to register a material. In this example, I've drawn a symbol I'd like to turn into a reusable asset. To register it as a material, I make sure the layer the drawing is on is selected, then go to Edit, Register Material Image. This should open up a window where you can name your material and classify what it's used for. Make sure you check the appropriate boxes based on what you intend for it to be used for. I'll elaborate on some of these other material types in the next episode, but for now, choose a location to save it in, make sure to tag it with any useful tags for easy searching, and then click OK. Now your drawing will be ready to drag and drop from the materials window anytime. When an image material is placed on the canvas, you can make additional adjustments to it under the Tool Property panel. You can choose which adjustments are visible in this panel by clicking the Wrench button to open the Subtool Detail panel, then toggling the Eye button next to whatever settings you'd like to add or remove. If you want to turn a material layer into a regular layer, just right-click and click Rasterize. Now it can be edited and transformed like any other raster layer. One of my favorite assets to use are texture overlays. By overlaying a texture on top of your art, it can add some visual interest or make it look more traditional. In the next episode, I'll be going over how you can make custom textures from scratch, but if you prefer to use something already available, there are lots of textures in the monochromatic folder in the materials panel you can apply to your canvas just by dragging and dropping. Once the texture has been placed on top of your canvas, fit it over the art until it's positioned how you like. From there, switch the layer mode to overlay and lower the opacity so the texture blends in with your colors. Once you've learned how to make assets for yourself, your work will be more cohesive and the possibilities for what you can accomplish are endless. Don't be afraid to make materials out of anything that might help you out. As you can see here, I've created custom brushes with different head angles for some of my characters to help with planning pages. You can make assets out of backgrounds, poses, characters, etc. My number one policy for working on comics is to always work as smartly as possible to avoid overworking, and Clip Studio Paint's materials make that really easy to do. Those are the basics for how you can use Clip Studio Paint's materials to help with making your webcomic. In the next episode, I'll be going more in depth about making and using materials, including how to make your own materials like brushes and textures from scratch. Check the description below for my social media links and more tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time.